Welcome back to the AI Heartbeat, your weekly digest. Will robots steal your job? The fear of AI taking over the workforce is real, but the reality is more complex than the headlines suggest. It is true that AI systems are becoming more capable and could potentially replace some jobs. But it's not all doom and gloom. A recent study found that 72% of people believe they will need AI skills to stay employable, and companies are actively seeking out workers with AI knowledge. We're on the brink of a new economy where experience and AI aptitude are equally valuable. Think about when typewriters were replaced by personal computers. We adapted then and will adapt now. People are already using AI tools to solve everyday problems like Copilot AI for meetings, which has led to increased productivity and efficiency in many businesses. But this shift also raises concerns. Studies have shown that AI could automate tasks in industries ranging from manufacturing to finance, potentially displacing millions of workers. For example, self-driving trucks could replace truck drivers, and AI-driven financial analysis tools could reduce the need for human analysts. This isn't just about numbers. It's about real people's livelihoods and their sense of purpose. And the concerns are even greater in healthcare, where regulations and ethical considerations are paramount. What do you think about the future of work in the age of AI? Are you excited, worried, or both? Now let's turn our attention to a fascinating yet complex development in healthcare that is happening down under. Australia's health regulator, the Australian Health Practitioner Regulation Agency, in short APRA, is grappling with a rising tide of complaints about AI being used to prescribe medications without direct human interaction. It's a trend that sparked concern among patients and doctors alike. People are questioning the safety and ethics of receiving prescriptions without ever speaking to a doctor. In response, APRA has taken action against practitioners who haven't followed proper telehealth prescribing guidelines. Yes, exactly. The human touch in healthcare is and always will be paramount. So what does this mean for the future of AI in healthcare? It is clear that as AI becomes more sophisticated, we need to develop clear ethical guidelines and regulations to ensure patient safety and maintain the doctor-patient relationship. The Australian experience is a stark reminder that while AI offers great potential, the human connection in healthcare remains absolutely essential and irreplaceable. What are your thoughts on AI prescribing medications without a live consultation? Do you think this is a safe and ethical practice? How can we ensure that technology enhances rather than replaces the human element of healthcare? And now moving on to our next story. Imagine getting a call back after a mammogram, anxiously waiting for more tests, only to find out it was a false alarm. It's a stressful experience that happens all too often. But AI is stepping in to help. Researchers at Washington University and White Rabbit AI have developed an AI program that can accurately identify normal mammograms. In a recent study, they found that this AI could help reduce false positives without missing any cancer cases. That means thousands of women could avoid the stress and anxiety of unnecessary additional testing. Have you or someone you know experienced the stress of a false positive mammogram? Do you think AI could help reduce anxiety and improve the breast cancer screening, this screening experience? As Dr. Jason Su, co-founder and CTO of White Rabbit AI, says, quote, "At the end of the day, we believe in a world where the doctor is the superhero who finds cancer and helps patients navigate their journey ahead," end of quote. AI isn't here to replace doctors, but to empower them to provide better care. By automating the identification of normal mammograms, AI frees up radiologists' time so that they can focus on more complex cases, potentially leading to earlier detection and more effective treatment for those who truly need it. It's a win-win for both patients and healthcare providers. Now let's explore a fascinating area of AI development that is pushing the boundaries of how technology understands us. Emotional AI. Yes, you heard it correctly. Emotional AI. Companies like Hume AI, Anthropic Tech, and Affectiva are pioneering this field, combining psychology and cutting-edge technology to decode our emotional responses. For businesses, this could be a game changer. Imagine understanding exactly how customers and consumers feel about your product or service. That's what Anthropic is doing, helping companies tailor their marketing and improve customer satisfaction by analyzing our cognitive and emotional reactions. But as with any powerful tool, there are ethical concerns to consider. Can AI truly understand the complexities of our human emotions? And what about privacy? Should companies be allowed to track and analyze our emotional responses without our consent? The tech giants are starting to grapple with these questions in a significant move. Microsoft, Hirvu, and Nielsen have recently discontinued their facial coding APIs, citing ethical and privacy concerns. This decision underscores the growing awareness in the tech industry about the need for responsible and ethical AI development. So, what does this mean for the future of emotional AI? It is clear that as this technology evolves, companies must prioritize ethical practices, transparency, and respect for user privacy. While the challenges are real, so is the potential of emotional AI. It could revolutionize how we personalize customer experiences, enhance mental health treatments, and create more empathetic human-computer interactions. So, what do you think about emotional AI? Do you believe it's a promising tool with the potential to improve our lives? Or do you think that it is an invasion of privacy that could be used to manipulate our emotions? How can we ensure it is used ethically and responsibly? And that's a wrap on this week's AI Heartbeat. We have explored just a few of the ways AI is shaking things up in healthcare, the economy, and even our emotional lives. AI is a complex and powerful force that is here to stay. I would like to hear from you. What are your thoughts on these stories? Do these stories make you feel hopeful or worried or a mix of both? Share your insights and questions in the comments below. And if you'd like to keep yourself informed, don't forget to subscribe to the AI Heartbeat channel. Thanks for watching. Meanwhile, stay curious. Thank you.